If you are a tutorial, check you too.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to stare. We saved her. I got my sister back. This is like the best feeling ever.
This version of us is being erased. I can feel it. Before we go, Carolina, I have to say it.
Don't.
Just promise me you'll find me. Wherever we are. I will.
But there's beauty here that's yet to depart. There's still a song inside the halls in the dark.
Her butt's a grass, right?
Not yet.
Don't leave me here, Simon. I can fight.
I'm sorry, Marcy.
Simon!
You have to keep it together, Simon. For her.
Simon, you promise.
Dun, da-da-da-da-dun-dun. Making your way in the world today takes everything you've got. Taking a break from all your worries sure would help a lot. Wouldn't it be nice to get away? Where everybody knows your name. Where everybody... Yeah. Marcy, look. I found chicken soup. You're gonna feel awesome in a moment.
I'm just glad you're okay.
Do you feel awesome?
Mm-hmm. I love you.
I must look a real mess.
Nah, you always look great after fighting a monster.
You think so? This is nice. We never get to dance. You're always the one performing.
I have a lot more songs I want to sing. Real sappy ones.
Good. I've always loved your songs.
Okay, but like I was saying, guys, we had a lot of great candidates. But this year, I chose the individual who earnestly represents Jesus's path on this earth, right? I mean, this young woman makes Christ proud. Every single day. So when you guys are struggling, right, and you're struggling on your path with the Lord, I want you to look to her for guidance.
Okay. This year's fellowship student leader is Sterling Wesley. Yes!
Wow.
Sterling, wait. Will you sit with me?
What is wrong with you? What was all that flirting with Luke?
I'm not ready to come out. I don't get you. What changed? I changed my mind.
It's allowed.
But I thought...
As long as my dad is my dad, I can't be all, you know, out there, sexually speaking.
I'm not asking you to headline a gay pride parade. I'm asking you to hold my hand to the lock-in. He would never even know.
Rumors travel fast.
To prison.
He got cleared of his charges. He's home. And surprise, surprise, he's not a big fan of the gays. I have to focus on my family, Sterling. Why don't you understand that? He's out. He's got a lot of stuff he wants to explain. And he wants to reconnect. He asked about you and Blair. which was so random considering we've been sworn enemies since the fifth grade, but it made me so freaked out that he heard something already. But I was probably just being paranoid.
The gardener did not even introduce herself to the new au pair. She barely acknowledged her at all. Simply treated her as if she'd always been there. The others in the room just assumed they'd already met. Which, if she were honest, was how the au pair felt when she first saw the young woman.
So who decided it was a good idea to feed these wee gremlins?
We're not gremlins. We're very good children.
Oh, is that right? See, I'm not so sure. I mean, what do you think?
Oh, it's hard to say. We're going to have to get water on them to be sure.
Like this.
There you go. Thank you.
Was there somebody working on the grounds today? Maybe a repairman or something?
No, I don't believe so.
Because I saw a guy on the parapet on my way in.
On the parapet?
Yeah.
You can't imagine.
Oh, I've not been up there.
Well, why would you?
Doctor?
I am a doctor.
I mean the real doctor.
The real doctor?
I'm looking for Dr. Katz. You're her, aren't you? Of course you are.
You're late, Dr. Lin.
I'm sorry, you just seem...
Young to be your boss? Well, I'm not, so get used to it.
Okay.
Tell me, why do we still insist on using stirrups?
I'm sorry?
They're outdated and completely unnecessary. I mean, why don't we just put a bit in the patient's mouth?
Would you like some help with this?
Are you Jewish?
No. Why?
You answered a question with a question. So you trained with Jason Kalfas?
Yeah.
Did you sleep with him?
No.
Shoot drugs with him?
No, God, no.
Hey, don't be defensive. This is just us getting to know each other.
Sorry.
Stop apologizing.
I'm not used to...
I have an Israeli disposition. I keep a kosher home, I leave early on Fridays, and when I get married, I will probably wear a wig. Do you have a problem with any of that?
Nope.
Good. First case, 34-year-old, 5 months pregnant, fell putting up a mobile.
Love you.
Thank you. Hey, stranger. I thought you left.
I did want to get on that plane. I was so mad and disappointed.
I'm sorry.
No. Not at you. At myself for pushing you away. I'm so glad you came.
Attention passengers, we have a gate change.
I got your letter. I think the first word is shalom.
Yeah.
But it's really hard to find someone who reads Hebrew.
Yeah, because there's no Jewish doctors working at a hospital.
Nope. I was standing in that office, and it was everything I'd worked for. And all I could think about was you. I love you. And I'd give everything up to be with you.
I would too. That's why I didn't get on the plane. I guess we'd both give it all up. You want to know what that says? Shalom, Maggie. From the Book of Ruth. Urge me not to leave you. Wherever you go, I will go. Where you lodge, I will lodge. Where you die, I will die. And there I will be buried.
You had me at shalom.
It's a strange, strange game. Love will never be the same.
Plane tickets are on me.
Jane. And you are Petra?
Yes, and I really don't need a lawyer.
Then why am I here?
My children's father felt I should hire someone.
Because you were the only person at the scene of the murder?
There was no murder. It was self-defense.
Not sure the DA would agree with you on that. I made some calls to see if there were any charges pending.
What? Are there?
No. Not yet. The 50-50, we're going to get there. And unfortunately, you're not the most sympathetic defendant. And this isn't your first time being a person of interest in a murder investigation.
Oh. Got it. And just to be clear, I know what this is about. Well, my expensive shoes. You know, my hotel is worth millions, so you're trying to make it seem like this is some complicated case that's going to require hundreds of billable hours. But let me be clear. This is not complicated. My sister attacked me. We struggled. She fell.
Now, let me be clear. Here's what's going to happen. First, the police are going to get a subpoena for your emails and phone records. Then they'll go after the hotel security footage. After that, they'll ask for the reservation records so they can interrogate all the guests and all of your hotel employees. So you may want to put your shoe shopping on hold because it is going to cost you a lot of money to get out of this. And you'll pay it to someone else because I'm not interested.
What are you doing here?
Raphael called.
You what?
He told me that you still had feelings for me. And he made this big speech about how life is too short, and I know it's corny, but my mom just died, and I've been thinking about you so much lately. And honestly, I never stopped loving you, and I just... about yours. Don't worry, she's gone too.
Hey, you. Laura Ingalls Wilder. We're escaping America before the apocalypse. Wanna come?
Sorry?
What can I get for you?
Oh, hi. I was wondering if you're hiring.
No, sorry.
But can I leave this with you?
Honestly, it's just gonna end up in a drawer somewhere, so.
Okay. Well... Can I have a margarita then?
That I can do for you.
It's a little cold out for a margarita, don't you think? Let's see this. Steve's Greek cuisine. Le Grand Fromage. Bullshit. You need a lesson in fudging a resume.
Do you work here?
Are you fucking kidding me? Manager Polly Harper. No one named Polly Harper gets put in charge. Who is that, really?
My friend.
You've never waited a fucking table in your life, have you? So, Piper Chapman. The Smith grad with excellent listening skills. Passionate about making diners feel good. That seems kind of dirty. Safe, clean, and careful when handling food and drink. I like that in a woman. What else do I need to know about you?
Who are you?
My name is Alex.
What do you do, Alex? Besides make fun of strangers in bars.
I work for an international drug cartel.